Then you know, how about sound to product? That sounds very scary. Actually, it is not. You see, if you look at here, the right-hand side is sound, the left-hand side is product. You can do from the right to the left, too. Okay? So, let's do one. Let's look at the first one. Okay? Now, you see, I want to cover some. I don't want to distract you. Let's look at that. Okay. If you have a alpha plus beta, sine alpha minus beta, from the right to the left will be from the sum to the product. But you know, I like alpha plus beta be U, and I like alpha minus beta be V. So then we know this is going to work for the two different angles, whatever they are given. So if I write alpha plus beta as U, alpha minus beta as V, as I did right here, U is alpha plus beta, so I can write alpha plus beta is U, alpha minus beta is V. Right hand side, I put down here, actually it's on the left now. Now if you have a alpha plus beta is U, alpha minus beta is V, then what are the alpha and beta? How are we going to express that? Up to this far, it should be very easy now, but I still can show you the process. Look, if you add those two, alpha positive, alpha beta positive, beta negative will cancel. So you have a 2 alpha equals U plus V. That's the one down here. 2 alpha equals U plus V. If you divide it by 2, then you have alpha is U plus V divided by 2. So then you have alpha here is U plus V over 2. So that's first one. Okay. How about second one? Beta. We did addition. You cancel beta. If you do subtraction on the right hand side, you are going to cancel alpha. Okay. So here is the case. You do subtraction, then you have a what? Minus, minus. Here minus, it will be plus. So then you have a 2 beta equals U minus V. Divided by 2 on both sides, you have a beta is U minus V divided by 2. So then we have a beta is U minus V divided by 2. Remember now, alpha is U plus V divided by 2, beta is U minus V divided by 2. Okay? Great. So this will be our first formula, from sum to the product. Okay? Now, we can derive another 2 or 3 formulas. Before we proceed, let's do some examples. So I'm going to look at this example. This example is given as sine of 2 theta plus sine 4 theta. That's in the product form. No, it's in the sum. You want to change the sum to the product. Okay. Now formula is right here. U is 2 theta, V is 4 theta. Okay. So you want to do is you have a 2 in front of it, so then you have a 2, and then U plus V, so 2 theta plus 4 theta divided by 2, okay. That's this one, and then cosine U minus V, so 2 theta minus 4 theta divided by 2, okay, and then 2, 4 together is 6, divided by 2 you have a 3, 6 theta divided by 2, so you have a 3, and here 2 minus 4 is negative 2 divided by 2, okay. Now keep going. You then have a what? You then have a sine 3 theta, cosine theta. Again, where is the negative sign? As I showed you, for cosine, negative, positive, they're equal. Eh? So, negative sign disappeared for cosine. Alright. Let me derive one more, and the other two you may want to enjoy yourself. Okay, now, you know, here is plus, then you have a U plus V over 2, U minus V over 2, okay? I may want to take this away. If we have more things right here, is a kind of distraction. I want to take this away. Okay. Put this in position. Now you know, you may want to handle if here is subtraction, how does it look like? Okay, now we know again previously if it's negative for sine, this negative sign goes out. Okay, so down here, if you have a subtraction here, this basically, it also tells us this negative sign can get in. See, if this negative sign gets out, then you may say if you have a negative sign in front of sine, it also gets into there. Here comes to be positive. You can look at this formula in two different ways. Right? Now, if here is negative, then you put this negative in, okay, and then the front comes to be positive. Well, here negative gets in is going to be like this, and then here is plus. So you can use this formula again. But the thing is that here is positive, and then inside is negative, so here is negative. Alright? Yeah. So in order to be consistent, let me put this negative sign above, right here. Okay? And then if here is negative for V, and here will be negative. Now it was negative V, and then you put another negative in front of negative, so here is going to be positive. Okay, so that's basically it says, you see, if here is negative, you get negative in, okay? And then you can do is u plus negative v, that's u minus v. That's the first one, okay? And then here is u plus v, so u plus v over 2. All right? Yeah, it's basically u negative v, and then minus plus. This is how we get negative. Ah, so if you have a negative, then you have a sign u minus v now. Here was plus. Ah, and then cosine u plus v. That's the formula too. Let me complete another two also. Okay. Maybe one. Now, which formula we should look at? And we are done with sine positive negative. So now the business is what? Business is cosine. Okay. All right. Now we have a right here. This one, you want to look at that. Let's look at this one first. Okay. To look at this one, you want to remember that you have a cosine alpha minus beta. Alpha minus beta is V. And then you have a cosine alpha plus beta. Alpha plus beta is U. So since here cosine V, because that's alpha minus beta, and here is cosine U. Alpha plus beta is u. Okay? So you can switch it. Cosine v, cosine u is actually cosine u plus cosine v. Okay? So then that will be cosine u plus cosine v on the right hand side. If it's on the right hand side, what I like to do is I want to write this on the left. Okay? So, we are done with formula 1, 2. I need to do is I want to fold it. Okay. So, cosine, we are looking at this one. So, I will move this one up a little bit. Okay, you can only see this formula. And then, you know, right here, cosine u, cosine v. Maybe not this one, maybe this one. So cosine u, cosine v, on the left. On the right hand, left hand side, you have a 2. I wrote on the right. Alpha is u plus v divided by 2. Okay, it's right here. Alpha is u plus v divided by 2. All right, and then beta is u minus v divided by 2. Okay. Yeah. U minus v divided by 2. So the formula down here, from here, will be cosine u, cosine v. And then 2 cosine alpha is u plus divided by 2, u plus v. Beta is u minus v divided by 2. Okay. So the product formula to sum is actually from the sum to the, from the product to sum. And then the inverse direction from sum to product is basically from the original one. Okay. Now,